Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. Viewers, you're here with me, Sheikh Mohammed Awal, again with a very important and interesting topic that I'm going to be explaining with you. You see, between the Muslims and the Christian, we go together exactly from the very beginning. But the pattern of the way have to do with the divinity of Jesus Christ, whether he was God or partly God, the Son of God, in between some kind of a little God on the side. I don't know about that one in Islam. And whether he is divine, whether he's the one that created the heaven and the earth. So when we talk about God, definitely we have to understand who God actually is and what is it that God does that makes him to be God. In Islam, we have all the attributes that connote someone who is God. But when we look at those attributes and try to confirm them with Jesus Christ, it doesn't hold water at all. But what is happening today is about Christendom and Islam. Without crucifixion, there would be no Christianity, because Jesus Christ have to die to neutralize the mysterious curse of mankind before we will be able to get salvation. That is what the Christians are advocating. And Islam is saying that Jesus Christ did not die, because to die, it is a very shameful act for any prophet to be killed the way he was supposed to have been killed. And so today I'm going to be giving you what the Bible said, what the Quran said. This is going to be part one. You know, was Christ indeed crucified? Revisiting the empirical evidence from the two books. I begin with Quran chapter 4, verse 158, where Allah said, وَبِكُفُرِهِمْ وَقَوْلِهِمْ عَلَىٰ مَرْيَمَ بُخْتَانًا عَزِيمٍ. Because of their unbelief, they say to Mary horrible things. In وَقَوْلِهِمْ إِنَّا قَتَلْنَا الْمَسِيحَ إِسَى بُنُ مَرْيَمٍ. And they say, we have killed Jesus Christ, the messenger of God, the son of Mary. Now, they don't believe he's a messenger of God, but they're just making a fun out of it. وَقَوْلِهِمْ إِنَّا قَتَلْنَا الْمَسِيحَ إِسَى بُنُ مَرْيَمَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ. He's the Messiah, okay, we kill him, the son of God. They were making fun of it. Then Allah said, وَمَا قَتَلُوهُ, they did not kill him. وَمَا سَلَبُوهُ, they did not crucify him. Why did Allah mention two type of death? وَمَا قَتَلُوهُ, meaning the Jewish did not kill him in any way, shape or form. وَمَا سَلَبُوهُ, the Romans did not hang him on the cross in any way, shape or form. Then Allah said, وَإِنَّ الَّذِي نَخْتَلَفُ فِيهِ لَفِي شَقٍ مِّنْهُمْ. Those who are involved about the case of him being dead and rose from the dead, Allah said, مَا لَكُمْ بِهِ مِنْ إِلْمٍ. They don't have the exact knowledge of what happened. They only follow conjecture, guesswork, fiction. That's what happened. That's what I think happened. That's what they say. Guesswork. Why are the disciples following guesswork? Because at the time that they came to arrest Jesus Christ, supposed to arrest him, none of them was there. Mark reported the scenario in the book of Mark, chapter 14, verse 50. Mark said, during the most critical time of Jesus Christ, the most important time that he needed support, during the most critical time of Jesus Christ, all his disciples forsook him and fled. All means all. None of them saw what happened. During the most critical time of Jesus Christ, when they came to arrest him, all the disciples forsook him and fled. So if you forsook him and fled, how would you give an account of what happened? That's why the Quran said, إِلَّا تِبَا أَزَّنْ مَالَكُمْ بِهِ مِنِ إِلِمْ. Those who write about whether he died or not, they don't have the exact knowledge. إِلَّا تِبَا أَزَّنْ. They follow conjecture. Then Allah said, وَمَا قَتَلُوهُ يَكِينَ. For surety, they did not kill him. بَلْ رَفَعَهُ اللَّهُ إِلَيْهِ. So you see, these words are very forceful, are very factual. They are pregnant with information that is so consistent with logic. Because if Jesus Christ actually died on the cross, that means he is a curse. He's someone that God cursed him. Why did I say that? The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 21, verse 23, all the way to verse 25, it says, if anyone committed a crime and you apprehended him and hung him on a tree, you should be able to bury him that same day. Because whosoever is hung on a tree is a curse from God, so that the land which the Lord has given you should not be defiled. Meaning, anyone that is hung on the cross is a curse from God. A curse. You know what is a curse? From God. So if the Christians believe that he died on the cross, that means it's a curse. So Paul was having this problem of Deuteronomy 23, 24, 25. He became so confused, and so he designed an answer to it. We find the answer in the book of Galatians chapter, 3 verse 13 to verse 14. It reads, Paul said, Christ, referring to Jesus, redeemed us from the curse of the law. Because it is written, whosoever is hung on the cross is a curse from God. He became a curse for us so that we will attain salvation. What kind of thinking is this? The Deuteronomy, who Jesus Christ said, I did not come to destroy. I came to fulfill. Yeah? John or Matthew chapter 5 verse 17, where Jesus said, do not think that I've come to destroy the law of Moses and the prophet. No, I've come not to destroy, I've come to fulfill. And I'm telling you, heaven and earth will pass, but a dot from the law shall not pass till all is fulfilled. And whoso therefore do the law of Moses and teach someone to do it will become great. But whosoever cancel the law. And here we have Paul trying to cancel the law, telling you and I in the book of Galatians that Christ became a curse for us. And he died to neutralize the mysterious curse. He went to hell and back. This is what Paul said. I did not say that. Don't go say it, Muhammad. I will say that so that I will have the blame. I didn't say that. It is Paul who said that. So he would come to, he's trying to reconnect and come and make some sense about what Deuteronomy said, that whosoever died on the cross is a curse from God. It's clear. Whosoever died on a tree is a curse from God. That's why God did not allow for him to be hung on a tree. Illatiba azan. They only follow conjecture. Christ loved life. If he definitely did not want to die on the cross when he went to the upper room crying and telling his disciple that this is not the case. In fact, I'm going to be dealing with the second part of this argument. This is the first part one. I'm going to be doing the second part, and I'm going to clarify some more, because this is a very big and large topic that I need to clarify so many things. I can't do it on this right now, because we don't want to make it too much for people to get tired watching the same old thing. So I'm going to come with my second part of this topic, inshallah, and I'm going to deal with it squarely until we get to conclusion of this all important matter. Hazza billahi tawfiq. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh.